Last thing I want to touch on is, how long do I pay my premiums for? I get that question a lot. How long do I pay my premiums for? And honestly, if you truly understand this banking concept, you will soon realize that you will never want to stop paying your premiums. And here's why. I'll tell you why. Because later down the road, because of the power of uninterrupted compounding interest, later on down the road, our loan is going to exceed our premium that we put into the policy. So think about it. If later on down the road, if I'm putting in 10 grand into my policy and I'm able to borrow out 13, 14, 15,000 for that 10 grand, I'm gonna be doing that all day long. That's a 50% increase in my money. So saying that if I sit here, you give me $10 and I give you $15, how long will you be doing that? You'd be coming back all day long. We'll be going back and forth, right? So personally, I will never stop putting premium into my policy just because of that growth. But let's talk about this. If you do ever want to stop paying your premium, you can. There's certain options. Let's say that your cash value inside the policy is going to be so great that you can actually just roll it over and pay for that premium each year. I kind of call this having your policy be on autopilot, right? Or maybe we'll switch the contract to a reduce paid up, meaning that it's going to keep the level death benefit of the policy and your cash value is just gonna roll over and pay for the premiums itself. Similar thing, but it's called a reduce paid up contract status. One thing you'll notice when reading the policy illustrations is your premium is going to drop, right? And we covered that a little bit last video. My rocket ship example, right? Your booster rockets are falling off the policy in year 10. And that's typically how I design it, is I design your full premium base and paid up additions rider to be attached onto the policy for 10 years. Just to show you, this is how it's gonna operate for the 10 years, right? But keep in mind, your paid up additions rider is extremely flexible. You are not required to pay into it if you choose not to. Like we said, that paid up additions rider later on down the road is gonna fall off, okay? And in your meetings with your mapping team, you will know when you want to drop that rider off of the policy. So to answer your question, really the only thing that we have to put into this policy is our base premium. That's the minimum that we have to put into this policy to keep it attached. And also, if you have a term rider, that term rider is also required. So if you don't have one, no worries, don't have to worry about that. But our base and the term rider are the two things that is the minimum that we have to put into this policy to keep it alive and active. So when reading those policy illustrations, and maybe you see that paid up additions rider being paid out to year 20 till age 65, just keep in mind, that paid up additions rider is not mandatory, thus you don't have to fulfill that full, true, total net premium.